Welcome to Janet's Planet, where we're traveling at the speed of thought. Have you ever wondered what happens when a rowdy riverboat captain is moved by the message of a traveling preacher?
Thomas Ryman was born in Nashville in 1841. During the Civil War, he serviced both the Union and Confederate armies, and in doing so, acquired quite a bit of wealth and started buying steamboats. One by one, Ryman bought his riverboats and bolstered his profits by offering gambling and alcohol. But there was a problem. Ministers holding tent revivals were coming to town discouraging drinking.
Don't do it.
Ryman's plan was to drive the preachers out of town by sending his workers to heckle the great believers. He and a group of his guys went over to the tent revival of Samuel Porter Jones. And before he could start to heckle, he became moved by what Samuel Jones was preaching about, and he became a born-again Christian.
Amen.
Ryman wanted to build a permanent church for traveling ministers. He was a man of vision and of his word. 14 years and $100,000 later, the Union Gospel Tabernacle was completed.
Yay!
Believers packed the new church to listen to the word of God.
Hallelujah!
Ryman and Jones' friendship deepened throughout the years. When Ryman died in 1904, his dear friend Sam Jones presided over the service to a packed house of 4,000 mourners. After the service, Sam Jones initiated a vote that the Union Gospel Tabernacle be renamed the Ryman in honor of his friend.
Hear, hear.
The vote was unanimous.
Let your mind revolve around this thought. Few things are harder to put up with than the annoyance of a good example. And that's the view from Janet's Planet.
Janet's Planet, let's go!